FM News. On point. A quick look at the news. I'm Lynn Komjisha. Minister of State for Higher Education John Chrysostom Muyingo has failed to convince members of parliament and the budget committee why government needs to buy the 9 million radios for learners who are yet to report back to school. In the third supplementary schedule table before the committee yesterday by the Minister of State for Planning, David Bahati shows that the Ministry of Education requires 336.8 billion Uganda shillings to procure 9 million radios. Muyingo, while leading officials from the Ministry of Education, informed MPs these radios will facilitate long-distance learning for students. Muyingo also informed members of parliament they do not know when schools will fully be reopened, saying this will depend on the assessment that will be conducted on schools, on how schools are implementing the COVID-19 SOPs.
It's the inspection that will be done that will inform the ministry of what to do next. It's too early to tell right now that we are opening in December, January, whatever. It will depend on the information that will come from the inspection from the ground. It also depend on the study our scientists are making. But for us as a ministry, we have to go ahead and plan to have our learners learn.
Now, the legislators argue that the ministry should complete the assessment before procuring radios to establish whether long-distance learning will be effective.
First of all, I want to report that it is not effective and it is not doing anything serious. Pupils are not running on radios.
Remember, we are going for a scientific elections whereby all the members of parliament are going to use radios. All the councillors are going to use radios. LC5 chairpersons are going to use radios. Presidential candidates are going to use radios. So, Chair, practically, what I am saying, this program is not tenable between now until after general election.
So, many households, according to your information, have got these radios. If they do, what is the necessity of buying every household a radio where there is already a radio?
Uganda National Examinations Board has asked parents to report to UNEB all schools that have hiked the registration fees for candidates. UNEB said Uganda shillings 34,000 for PLE, 164,000 for O-level and 186,000 for A-level candidates. The principal examinations officer, UNEB, in charge of PLE, Rose Neville Kenya Mukasa, says the deadline for registration is still on the 20th November, but parents should not be overcharged.
UPE candidates and the UZ candidates and UCOLETs, we expect them to be at school right now, and the schools should be sending their registration as soon as possible. All the portals are open. We have checked, of course, some information has come from the schools, and we encourage all schools to continue doing the same. There has been a question of the centers which have been approved of late. Actually, the board approved the last centers yesterday. We normally have an arrangement for those who get their centers within the year of registration. So we shall guide them accordingly. But otherwise, the dates of registration still stand.
10 Kiseka market vendors who were arrested by police demonstrating over government's decision to take over the market have been remanded to Kitalia prison. The 10 have appeared before Buganda Road Court Grade 1 Magistrate Stella Amabilis, who read to them the charge of inciting violence to destroy a police vehicle. The accused are Joseph Kitandwe, John Damuria, Kenneth Musinguzi, Moses Akugziwe, Geoffrey Musonera, Musa Mutwalib, Nebos Musinguzi, Charles Sewanonda, Mashid Kizito and John Tamale. They have all denied the charges. Prosecutor Mariam Njuki has informed the court that investigations into the matter are ongoing and prayed that they remand the accused persons. Consequently, Magistrate Amabidis has remanded them until November 12th when he will consider their bail application. Police is holding 15 suspects who were found in possession of unauthorized military uniform. The spokesperson of the Police Investigations Department, Charles Twiner, says the suspects were arrested in an operation conducted in Kayunga, Buikwe, Njeru, and Buvuma.
In Buikwe District, 10 red berets were recovered, 3 black berets, 3 army green berets, 13 army trousers were recovered, 8 army shorts were recovered, 2 army jackets, 2 army shirts, and 2 army skirts. This operation led to the arrest of the following people: Bogo Enoch, then Bongo Fred, Kakomo Peter, Mwanje John, Latono Hajara, Aisibe Freista, Naswa Lilian, Nanyanz Martha, Namud Florence, and Utamsize Yusuf. In Injeru, two body armors were recovered.
In other news, after 10 hours of voting, polls have officially closed in Tanzania's election, where 15 candidates are running for the presidency, including the incumbent John Pombe Magufuli. More than 85,000 polling centres across the country closed at exactly 1600 local time. The authorities say the process was largely peaceful, despite social media restrictions and claims of irregularities. Two main opposition parties, Chadema and ACT Wazalendo, have claimed there were widespread ballot tampering. In a tweet, Tundu Lissu, Chadema's presidential candidate, said they had received reports indicating widespread irregularities. He also alleged that opposition polling agents were prevented from accessing some polling stations. The National Electoral Commission chairperson denied the claims, saying they are unfounded. In the island of Zanzibar, polling passed off peacefully a day after violent clashes in which ACT Wazalendo claimed 10 people were killed. Police, however, denied the claims but added that 40 people had been arrested in the region. That was the news.